other hadith. So in this hadith we understand some of the signs, the characteristics of a good sister. Is that she is the one that she pleases her husband when he looks at her. Secondly, she obeys if he gives her the command or if he tells her to do something. And thirdly, she does not refuse him when he calls her to his bed. عن كعب بن عجزة قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رواه الطبراني this hadith in صحيح الجامع as well. All the hadith I'm going to speak today inshallah ta'ala they're mostly in السلسلة الصحيحة for Sheikh Al-Albani or they are in صحيح الجامع inshallah ta'ala also for Sheikh Al-Albani رحمه الله تعالى. So all of the hadith inshallah are authenticated by him رحمة الله عليه رحمة واسعة. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أخبركم بنسائكم من أهل الجنة؟ Shall I tell you those women that will accompany you to Jannah? He's giving us the characteristics of those women that will accompany their husbands into the Jannah. So let the sisters pay attention, inshallah ta'ala. Al-Wadud, the one that loves her husband to the extreme. Allahu Akbar. Al-Wadud, the one that is in love with her husband. Sometimes sisters are not loving them with their husband, and that is the biggest mushkila. If you're not in love, then nothing can work. Nothing can work in this marriage. If the wife does not love her husband deeply in her heart, then nothing can work out in such a family. It is better to separate between those two individuals, because it's all going to lead, it's going to lead into biggest mashakil and problems and problems and problems and so on. So love is the basics of the Muslim family. Al-A'ud, very important characteristics. Al-A'ud, ay allati ta'udu ila zawjiha. Al-A'ud is the one that returns to her husband. Ay sa'id sari'at al-rida. She is the one who is very fast in pleasing her husband. Being pleased. So she can get him upset, because that is the nature of most women. They can sometimes make their husband upset. But she is the one that always can come back quickly and rectify her mistakes. Or the other way around, and that is if she gets upset, she's the one that can be pleased easily. Not 1 month, lock herself in a bedroom and say, I don't want to talk to you, your husband. La. Al-A'ud. Very important characteristics. Some women, they cannot last 1 night while her husband is pleased with them. Upset with her. Some women, subhanAllah, some women can last 30 days, the guy will go crazy. 30 days, she doesn't care. You turn your face away from them in the bed, she said, yeah, that's for you, ya Sheikh. Never turn back. Never turn back, she will never care. 30 days she can last. That skin will go crazy. No wife for 30 days, chicken HFC every day, skin. That type of woman is not good. Al-A'ud, you need to look, this is a very important characteristic. Why is it important? Because women, as we said, in the hadith of Rasulullah sallam, they are like, they're made from a burnt, what do you call? Rib. The burnt rib. So by nature, they will make many mistakes. By nature, because she's a human being, she's not an angel. She is a human being. So this characteristic is very important. That whenever she gets upset, she's easy to be pleased. Or when her husband gets upset, she's the type of person that come quickly to please her husband. Al-A'ud. Allati idha zulimat qalat, she is the one whom, if injustice is being done against her, yani her husband made her upset. Look at this very important characteristic. She's the type of woman whom, if her husband does injustice against her, qalat, she says, hadhihi yadi fi yadika, this is my hand in your hand. La adhuqu ghamdan, la adhuqu ghamdan hatta tarda. But this is my hand in your hand, by Allah, I will not taste rest or sleep until you are pleased. Allahu Akbar. This is the beautiful characteristics of a believing woman. She is the one that will say to her husband, when she puts her hand into his hand, and she will say, Wallah, I will not sleep until you are pleased. Until you are pleased. Even if she is the one who's been wronged. Because here it says, إِذَا ظُلِمَتْ أَيْ الرَّجُلُ وَظَالِمُ. When injustice is being done against her, and her husband is sad from her, she is the one that comes and she rectifies it quickly. Even though it wasn't her mistake, it was his mistake. She says, Wallah, I will not sleep, nor will I taste rest until you are pleased. Okay. عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال عن زيد بن أرقم. So inshallah ta'ala, this is also a very important lesson. Al-Wadud al-A'ud. Very important sign that a brother should look into when he's trying to get married to a sister. Very important that you should look into a wife. She has to be Al-Wadud al-A'ud. And this is also something good for the sister who's already married. She needs to develop these characteristics if she hasn't got it. And if she's got it, she has to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given her these beautiful characteristics of the woman of Jannah. Nisa'u ahl al-Jannah. They are those who will follow their husbands into the Jannah. Okay. How great is the right of your husband? How great is it? To what stance does it reach? To what level does it reach? Let us look at the hadith of Zayd ibn Arqam radiallahu anhu qal. أن معاذ قال that معاذ he said قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said يا رسول الله أرأيت أهل الكتاب يسجدون لأساقفتهم وبطارقتهم أفلا نسجد لك he said oh messenger of Allah have you not seen the people of the book when they come to their kings and their monks they make sujood for them they make sujood for the kings when they come and see them don't we make sujood for you Since you have very important status, Rasulullah he replied to Sa'd, Ma'ad, he said, لَكُنْتُ أَمِرًا أَحَدًا If I were to command someone to make sujood for someone, لَأَمَرْتُ الْمَرْأَةَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِزَوْجِهِ I would have asked the woman to make sujood for her husband. This hadith alone is sufficient to tell the believing woman the status of your husband. The status of your husband. In the previous hadith, we saw that he is the one that can lead you to Jannah. In this hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, إِذَا كُنْتُ أَمِرًا أَحَدًا أَنْ يَسْجُدَ لِأَحَدٍ If I were to command someone to make sujood to someone, I would have commanded the woman to make sujood for her husband. Why? The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَلَا تُؤَدِّ الْمَرْأَةُ حَقَّ زَوْجِهَا Or in another narration, he said, مِنْ عِذَمِ حَقِّهِ عَلَيْهَا Why is this status? Because of his rights over her. لِعِذَمْ Due to the greatness of his rights over his wife, if somebody was allowed to make sujood for someone, I would have asked the believing woman to make sujood for her husband. Subhanallah al-Azim. So the Muslim woman, she has to understand the status of her husband. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم he said in this hadith, وَلَا تَجِدُ امْرَأَةً حَلَاوَةً إِيمَانِ Pay attention here. A woman would not find the sweetness of Iman. Some sisters might become defensive. Allahu musta'an. Why so important? What does he think he is? It's not to me, يَبْنَةَ الْمُسْلِمِين. The daughter of the Muslim, it's not to me who's telling you this. This is Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given men this status and this importance in their life, their husbands, wives. So this is what Allah and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are commanding you to do. And that is why I say a brother should not hasten into marriage unless he's careful of the type of woman that he's going to marry. And a woman should not be very hasty and quick in accepting the marriage of a brother unless she wants and she's pleased with his characteristics. Because tomorrow she has to obey him. She has to obey him. Because he is her Jannah and he is her hellfire. As we will see in the hadith. In this hadith he said, a woman will not taste halawat al-iman. The sweetness of iman. Hatta tu'addi haqqa zawjiha. Until she fulfills the rights of her husband. Number one, what is it? At-ta'ata. Number one, his rights is to be obeyed. He is to be obeyed. Whether what he tells you pleases you or it does not please you, as long as he's not contradicting Allah and his Rasul, you need to obey him. That is why you need to be careful of the brother that you need to marry before it's too late. If he's very harsh, then you have to obey him as well. If he's very soft, then alhamdulillah, he'll be very lenient towards you. But you need to obey your husband. Okay. ولو سألها نفسها وهي على ظهر قتب أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Okay. So inshallah ta'ala, here we also saw that halawat al-iman, a believing woman can taste the sweetness of iman if she obeys her husband and she gives him his rights. In another hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn Abi Awfa, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفس محمد بيده, I swear by the one whom my soul, the soul of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is in his hand. Allah سبحانه وتعالى لا تؤذي المرأة حق ربها حتى تؤذي حق زوجها كله. A woman would not fulfill the rights of her lord Allah until she fulfills the rights of her husband. Hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. A woman would not be able to fulfill the rights of her Allah, the lord. Pay attention. Until she fulfills the rights of her husband. فَرِّضَ اللَّهِ فِي رِضَ الزَّوْجِ. To please Allah is to please your husband. And to displease Allah is to displease your husband. That's why, let us finish this issue of, Wallah, I love her looks. And she said, Wallah, I love his looks. After tomorrow, looks don't work. When I tell you, I don't want you to leave my house without my permission. You say, whoa, what do you think I am? Huh? Yeah, but yesterday what happened? It's all the matter of looks. Wallah, I love the way he looked. Wallah, she loved. Wallah, I love the way he recited the Quran like Sulaisi. It does not work now. Now is the world of reality. When a man understands his rights, he can be straightforward and say to you, these are my rights. And I do not want you to transgress against them. Okay? So the sister have to be paying attention, inshallah ta'ala. Okay. So here inshallah ta'ala, this hadith, we understood that the to please your Allah is to please your husband. It will not help you if you pray Qiyamul Layl and you pray Tahajjud, the same Qiyamul Layl and Tahajjud, and you fast Mondays and Thursdays, and you do everything.